NASA's most powerful rocket has been standing on a launch pad at the Kennedy Space Center now for a full month.
Yeah, launch and ground teams have been working through a series of tests before the lunar rocket can launch for an uncrewed mission in just a few months. Westview's Scott Heidler has the update from NASA on the Space Coast.
The third time was not the charm yesterday. NASA teams scrubbed the third attempt of a wet dress rehearsal for the Artemis 1 SLS rocket Thursday. It was rolled out to Launch Pad 39B 4 weeks ago for the testing. As they were tanking the massive 32-story tall rocket, a leak was found on the ground system that hoses the cryogenic propellant into the SLS. But NASA officials giving a wet dress rehearsal update, saying that's what this intense round of testing is about, finding the leaks and other issues now, not closer to launch day.
Mega Moon rocket is fine. But all the issues that we're encountering, I would say, again, are procedural and lessons learned, with the exception of this ground umbilical plate that we've got to go figure out where the leak is.
And they are confident that they can work that out in the next few days, as the current plan is to restart the wet dress rehearsal next Thursday, just 2 days before NASA and SpaceX launch the Crew 4 mission to the International Space Station on the launch pad next to Artemis. When questioned about the issues with the weeks of testing, NASA Artemis program leadership adding that it's in line with the testing during the shuttle and Apollo programs. Also announced, the AX-1 mission that launched the first all-private crew to the International Space Station 1 week ago will undock on Tuesday and splash down here off the coast of Florida on Wednesday morning. On the Space Coast, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.